prepare theory first so that you will be able to solve the first question, compulsory question. Then hello everyone, welcome to Plutus IS. I am CA Sonali Jindal. Today we will discuss the tips and tricks to score high in commerce and accountancy optional. Now there is two papers, paper 1 and paper 2. It is further divided into in paper 1 part A. They ask about the financial and post accounting. Then the topic is taxation and audit. In part B there is a further categorization into financial management and financial institutions. In paper 2, part A ask about the organization behavior and organization theory. In the part B, they ask about the HRM and IR. I hope you already know there will be question 1, 2, 4 will be from the part A and question 5 to 8 will be in the part B. First and fifth question will be the compulsory. And it can be asked from any of the topics. So you can't leave any of the topic because they can be asked in the compulsory question, question 1 and 5. And in fact, paper 1, 3, theory and numericals is being included. So at least prepare theory of every topic so that you can write the paper question number 1 and question number 5 because these are compulsory. And these are questions of 50 marks each. It means question 5th and 1st will be of 100 marks. And while writing the paper, you can decide to write 1st and question 5th firstly initially in around 1 hour. If you will complete 1st and 5th question in 1 hour initially, then you will be more confident so that you will be left with at least 2 hours. It can extend to 1 hour 15 minutes, but not more than that. Because you have to basically calculate the time, like for each question, how many minutes are required. In the paper 1, numericals also needed to be solved. So there is a need of more time to solve them. So initially solve the 1st and 5th question, then you can like look into the other question that can be chosen. Like from the pending 3 questions of each part, you have to attempt 1 question at least from each part. Thereafter, you can decide from which part you can write 2 questions. Try to choose from the more scoring part. For example, I am like dwelling into the paper 1. Here my first suggestion is to focus on theory more than the numericals, because in the numericals there is a need of accuracy. If you have like in the middle of the answer you find out yet you have done it wrong, then your confidence will be decreased. And the second thing is you will not get marks in theory. At least if you have filled up the one page, there is a chance of getting at least 2 to 3 marks. And in the theory, you can like write off 145 to 175 marks at least from the theory. Because maximum like practicals you can attempt is of 190 marks around. I will show you the paper, like how will you choose. Before that, focus on part B more. Because why I'm suggesting it? Because FM numericals are easy to solve, it takes less time. And in fact, FM and FI, like from the part B, you can attempt the paper of 150 marks. In this way, basically, you can like score more in the less time. Like if you have less time, try to focus more on FM and FI. You will be get done with the 150 marks. Then you can decide to like prepare the theory of part A, as you will get the theory questions in the question 1. Like after completing the part B, 150 marks are already being done. Then the first question will be also of theory. Then 50 marks can be obtained from it. Obviously, you will not get the full marks, but we are just seeing like preparation level of that paper. So 150 marks from the part B, 50 marks from the first question by preparing just theory. And the next question from second to fourth, you can decide to choose that question which includes the theory questions more. For example, there will be like categorization. I will show you the paper. This is 2021 paper. Now you can see first question ask about the theory. There will be 5 questions. Second question includes 20 marks numericals, then 15 marks theoretical questions and 15 marks theoretical question. You can choose this question. This way you have to attempt only numerical of 20 marks. So this is a clear cut shortcut strategy for the paper 1. Prepare FM and FI first, because it takes less time to solve the numericals of the FM, financial management. And secondly, you will be done with the 150 marks. Then move to the theory part of the part A, because there are numerous subjects. There are 4 subjects. We have already seen financial accounting, cost accounting, taxation and audit. Prepare theory first so that you will be able to solve the first question, compulsory question. Then choose the at question from the pending 3 questions, which includes the less marks numericals. In fact, it will save your time and energy in the paper. Now you can see other questions. Third question includes the numerical of. In fact, I would recommend you to leave the taxation numerical. Obviously, sometimes we have to make a, like, obviously choose a taxation question, because we are not able to basically solve the other questions. In emergency situation, obviously we have to choose. You can't leave them as such. But in taxation, you can prioritize salary head, house property head, because these are easy to be solved. And also prepare the deductions, because in the total income, while you are being given the question of salary or house property, you are also given the deduction. And also prepare the set off and carry forward. So in the taxation topic, for the numericals, I recommend this topics to be prepared. And in the alternative, you can choose to leave the taxation question. The other numerical is of 15. So instead of second question, if you will choose the third question, then you have to attempt the 35 marks numericals from the part A. So we are making a strategy. We will prepare FM and FI first, then we will prepare the theory part of the part A, so that we will be able to attempt the first compulsory question of the part A. Then we can attempt that question which includes the numerical less marks of numericals. Now moving back to the slides, we were making the strategy relating to the paper 1. So we will focus more on theory part, because it includes the 145 to 175 marks. Then we will choose to focus on the part B, FN and FI, less labors, and 150 marks will be scored and numericals takes the less time. Then in the priority, if you will make a priority between the part A subjects, then after FN and FI, you will prepare the cost accounting, then the financial accounting, then the taxation and then the audit. Obviously, you will focus more on theory in these respective subjects. Then in the numericals or the practical questions, I would recommend you to make a proper working notes, give the clear-cut assumptions relating to that topic. For example, the question is on capital budgeting. Basically, in that, maybe IRR is given or they have asked about the cost of capital. Try to mention the assumptions made for the respective topics and give the clear-cut conclusion. Obviously, detailed solution for the taxation you can basically leave, and for the final accounts, maybe in the lengthy questions, you can leave these provisions, numericals, because it will take more time. And also give them proper narration for the general entries. For the practicals, numerical questions, you need to include all these to score more. Now, I want to tell you to the common points that are relevant to the both papers, paper 1 and paper 2. Thereafter, we will see the paper 2 specific points. First thing is prepare micro topics. You can obviously watch the detailed strategy video relating to the paper. There we have seen how the micro topics have been asked directly. One page theory notes need to be prepared. For example, if they have given the line motivation, concepts, theories, here the micro topic is application. You need to prepare the application of these. Then prepare the difference between the topics. I've already discussed if the AND word is used between the topics, they can ask about the difference. Then prepare your notes by including the PYQs, because there are numerous repeated themes. Because if you will ask me one thing like, ma'am, I have only 1 month to prepare the any of the optional, what should be the strategy? I would recommend you to take the note of the 2014 to 2024 PYQs. Cram the answers of these, you will be done with the any of the optional. Obviously, you can reach to the 220 to 250 marks. After that, there is a need of answer writing practice. What are the repeated themes from the paper 1? Cost reduction and versus cost control. Residential status, they have asked about numerous times. They have asked directly about the different heads of the income. They have asked about the deductions. And in fact, practical questions have been repeated at least three to four times. Solve them thoroughly so that if the same question appears in the exam, you will take less time there, and then you will also get the confidence less that you are solving it rightly. Then the repeated themes from the paper 2, talent management has been asked, motivational theories, Herzberg matrix, organization. This is the basically star topic. They have asked it for more than 3-4 times. They have asked about the WPM worker participation management, future prospects, ILO, line and staff conflict, prevention and settlement of the industrial disputes. These are repeated themes. There are other repeated themes as well. For that, you have to analyze the previous year questions. I want to show you some of the questions of the previous years. Like in the syllabus, they have mentioned the word dividend. Like line is company audit. In the syllabus, it is mentioned divisible profits, comma, dividend. They have asked about the dividend. See, different heads of the income. Explain briefly each head. This is the direct syllabus line. See, different difference between two topics has been asked. These are being given in the topic syllabus as like this only. Job costing and process costing, they have asked the difference. See, residential status, I have said, this is a repeated theme. Deduction, they have asked. They have asked the difference between the divisible profits and dividends. I have already told you the syllabus line, divisible profits and dividends. They have asked the difference out of it. So try to see syllabus again and again. Look at the micro topics, then analyze the previous year questions thoroughly. After that, most important part is answer writing. Then the paper 2, I would recommend you to focus more on OT, organizational theory. It is in being asked in the part A, I've already said. And from OT, you can attempt the paper of at least 100 marks. With only one subject, you will get 100 marks. And there is a more scope of using thinkers in it. And in fact, you will get the understanding of the paper 2 only and only if you will understand the organizational theory, because the actual evolution of the organization theories is being explained in this subject only. Then only you will be able to use the thinkers in the HRM and IR. You will be able to use the thinkers more if you will understand the OT. And attempt 2+1 questions from the part A. I have already told you in the part A, you will get the questions of OT and OB. First question will be the compulsory, and the rest three from the three questions, you can choose to write two questions. This way, you will be able to use thinkers more, because in the HRM and IR, there is more generic information less scope of using the thinkers, here you will get the edge. In fact, I have seen the students where they have make a jump in the marks. In fact, myself has made the jump of 15 marks with the making the right choice by choosing two questions from the part A. Then prepare the list of the thinkers that can be used everywhere. I will also show you some of the thinkers, like how can you make a use of it. For example, if you're writing the question of matrix organization, you're writing it is against the unity of command. Mention fuel in the future, like in the bracket. Instead of writing lame points and just writing the generic points, try to make a reference of the different thinkers. This way only you can increase and fetch more marks in the paper too. Next, thinker-based definition introduction. Like for example, question says, it is asking about the performance appraisal. Try to make a introduction with the thinker-based definition. If any of the topic is asked, try to make a relevance. But obviously, like you can't make a, like prepare a definition that of that topics that are not mentioned in the syllabus. At least prepare a thinker-based definition of the topics that are mentioned in the syllabus and that has been asked in the previous year questions at least. Use crunch examples. Try to give the best case studies, crunch relevance examples. What are the best practices being used by the different companies? In fact, there is a scope of using them in HRM and IR more. In fact, we can get an edge because there is also a less scope of using the thinkers there. That way, we can replace them with the crunch examples. Then, let me show you some of the examples. How can you use the thinkers that you have read in the OT and OB in the HRM and IR? Like for example, if in the IR you are saying like there is a need of sanitation, there is a need of some cleanliness so that you can reduce the absenteeism or the labor turnover. You can mention the Herzberg there, two-factor theory, that is the motivation theory we read in the organization behavior, but we can use in the HRM and IR also. In the case, we can use the Keith Davies to show the significance of the informal organization or to show the emotional connect. Like for example, if you're seeing there is a need of like basically listening to the problems of the basically employee in the HRM performance appraisal, you are saying you are just not rating them directly, try to listen them also. Mention Keith Davis there. Communication, try to mention Chester Bernard in the bracket. Elton Mayo jo hai, that can be used multiple times there and there. Because Elton Mayo is of the neoclassical, it has mentioned the employee as a human. It can be used in the quality circles, maybe quality, work life, WPM, in the different topics it can be used. MacGregor theory why. If you will ask me which two thinkers at least should be appearing in your paper, these two thinkers at least mentioned twice in the paper, Elton Mayo and MacGregor theory why. It can be used in the HRM. Maslow self-actualization you can use in WPO, management by objective, 360 degree feedback. Then the BF Skinner positive reinforcement, it can be used in the HRM and IR. See, you will read it in the OB or OT, but try to learn them to see where it can be used in the HRM and IR. Then VV Giri for the collective bargaining. So the conclusion would be, try to make maximize the use of thinkers. Whenever you read any thinker theory, basically try to see where it can be used. Obviously, when you will be reading the HRM, maybe you have not read the OB or OT. So when you do any subject doing the self-study, you have to read all the subjects, then you have to again read them to see where it can be used again. And when you get the mentor guidance, like for example, if you will come to a classroom, then I can tell you in the HRM you can make a relevance of these thinkers there. Try to make a list on yourself, but you have to complete the syllabus first. Prepare some quotes for paper 2, but please don't prepare the quotes which are being used in the essay or ethics paper, because just if you write the quote for the leadership, maybe like that will not make any sense. You have to specify, you have to mention the application of that quote. For example, Matt Grigor has said, creativity and ingenuity is not narrowly distributed but a widely distributed. This is a relevant quote to show the significance of every employee, how the employee can contribute to the organization. That way you can specify the topics where it can be used in your notes itself, so that whenever you will revise them again, you will be able to see the use of them. In fact, try to multiply this use. Maybe like after two, three reads, you will find some other topic also where it can be used. WPM, QC and MBO. Then Keith Davies, it says management has not created informal organization and can neither destroy it or better use it. It can be used in the decentralization topic or in the informal organization. To show the man as a basically social animal, you can use this definition. Herzberg, I have already told you for the sanitation. So let's make a strategy. Finally, for the paper 1, I have told you, I'm just summarizing whatever I have said. Paper 1, you will focus on the theory, and part B, more FM and FI. You will prepare from syllabus and then previous year questions. We have already seen what the priority should be made to the subject, but this way focus more on theory and part B, FM and FI. And finally, for the paper 1 and paper 2, I want to say there is pyramid which way you prepare. Like firstly, you will read the books or some basically reference materials to prepare. Then you make the notes. Then you have to see the previous year questions. Then comes the part answer writing. But in the classroom, we will try to compile them all. We will make a notes by including the previous year questions and syllabus, and we will also practice the questions. Hopefully this video will help you to maximize your score in the paper 1 and paper 2. Thank you.